Here you check the problem number 11.12. What is this problem? This problem says that we may fit y equal to capital A into capital B raised to x to the given data. What are the data? Here x and y are given. Okay. What is the values for x? X is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Then y is 1.6, 14.5, 13.8, 40.2. 125. These are the y values, and we have to fit this situation using the curve formula y equal to a into b raised to x. So here the given model is y equal to a into b raised to x, and you know that first of all we have to transform this model into a linear model. For that, you know the technique is just take the logarithm on both sides. So taking logarithm, this formula becomes log y is equal to log a plus, because this model is a product model. So taking logarithm, that becomes summation. So log a plus log b raised to x is x into log b. So now this given model becomes a linear model. So you may write, instead of log y, it is capital Y. Instead of log a, it is small a. Instead of log b, it is small b. So this model becomes y equal to a plus bx. Okay, y is equal to a plus bx is the new model. Okay, so you transform this model like this. The given model is a curve model. So you transform that model as a linear model. Now, here you know that capital Y is log Y and small a is log of capital A, B is log of capital B. Now from the linear model, you know that here we have two unknowns, that are A and B. So to get the values for these unknown constants, we have to formulate two normal equations. And you know that two normal equation, how to get that normal equation, that you know the procedure. Okay, so these are the normal equations. You take the summation on both sides to this equation, then this becomes sigma y is equal to sigma a plus b into sigma x. Here sigma a means a is a constant, so you add a n times, that becomes n a. So this is the first normal equation. And to get the second normal equation, you have to multiply this model with the capital small x. Here the variable is small x, so you multiply this model into small x and take then summation. Okay, so the model becomes sigma xy. So you multiply this model with the x, it becomes xy ax plus bx square. Okay, so then take the summation, it becomes sigma xy is equal to a into sigma x plus b sigma square. So this is the second normal equation. Now from the given data, you have to find out these values except the constants. Other values are we can find out that values from the given observations. So what are the terms we have to identify from the given observation? First one is sigma y. So you have to find out sigma y. Then n means number of observations, sigma x, then here sigma xy, sigma x that we have already computed, then sigma x square. These are the values that we have to find out from the given observations. For that, you may prepare a table. First, you write down the x values. These are the x values. Here, not that the x values are points. They are not given as years or months. They are points. Suppose the x values are given in years. So before doing this computation, you have to transform that years into a new variable. Then the computation becomes an easiest procedure. Okay. So here the values of x is smaller value. So no problem. You can proceed. Then the y values are also given in the problem. Okay. Then to transform this given equation into linear equation, in the transform the equation, you know that we need capital Y. We don't want small y. Instead of that, we need capital Y. So you have to compute capital Y. What is capital Y? It is log Y. So you take the logarithm of these values. Use the logarithm table, or you can use the scientific calculator. In your scientific calculator, there is a button for log. So you put the log button there, you will get the logarithm value. So here, not that the logarithm is common logarithm. That means logarithm to the base 10. So using the logarithm, you get the log value for 1.6 is this value 0.2041. Similarly, you find out the logarithm for all these y values, only for y values, not for x values. So you find out the logarithm for all these log y values, you will get the variable capital Y. Then from the formula, you need sigma xy. For that, you find out small x into y. Here small x is this one, and you multiply that with the log y, you will get this value. Okay, so you can find out the all the values in this column, and find the sum of these values. That sum is sigma xy. Here you got sigma y is summation of these values, then sigma x, these are required for our equation, normal equations. Okay, now find out x square. X square means you just square the x values. Here 1 square it is 1, 2 square it is 4, like that way you find out the square of all these values. Okay, then find out the sum of all these square values. The sum of all these square values is sigma x square, that is 55 here. Okay, so the first stage is completed. Now we have to find out the unknown constants. What are the unknown constants? The unknown constants in the normal equation are small a and small b. Here what is n? N is how many observations? 5 observations. So n is 5. So you put these values in these two normal equations and solve these two normal equations, you can find out the values for a and b. Here substituting these values into the first normal equation, you'll get the first normal equation as like this. Here this term is sigma y. What is sigma y? It is 5 point something. Okay, n is 5, a is unknown. Then what is this one? It is sigma x square. What is sigma square? It is 55. Sigma n a into, sorry, it is what about that equation? Sigma y is equal to na into b into sigma x. Okay, sigma x. So what is sigma x? It is 15. Okay, sigma x is 15. So you substitute that 15 here. Okay, so that is about the first normal equation. Similarly, in the normal equation, you first substitute sigma xy. What is sigma xy? It is 21 point something. That is sigma xy. That is equal to a into sigma x. Sigma x is 15, then b into sigma x square. Sigma x square is 55. So you get two equations. From this two equation, you can see that we have two unknowns, a and b. So to get the values for a and b, you have to solve these two equations. We have two unknowns and two equations. So you have to solve that equation. Then how to solve that equation? You check the coefficients of a and b here. Here the coefficient of a is 5 in the first equation and coefficient of a is 15 in the second equation. So how to make the coefficient of a is same as the coefficient of the a of second equation? So you just multiply the first equation with 3. So this becomes 3 into 5, it is 15. So subtracting the first equation from second equation, you can cancel that term involving a. So that equation becomes an equation which contains only one unknown value, that is b. So you can find out the value for b. So here you subtract the first equation, you multiply the first equation with 3 and subtract that from the second equation. Okay, so that means 21.8315 minus 3 into 5.6983, that is equal to, then solve that two equations. You just subtract the second equation, you multiply the second equation with 3 and subtract that from the second equation. Okay, so by solving this equation, you can see that it is 10b is equal to like this. So that equation becomes only one unknown b. A is cancelled. Okay. So from this you can find out b is like this. So b is 0.4737. So you got the value for the second constant b. Now using this value in any of these two equations, you will get the value for a. You substitute this value in the first equation or in the second equation, you will get the value for a. Here I substitute this value in the first equation. So in the first equation, instead of b, you use this value 4.4737. Then you will get the value for a. In the first equation, now you have only one unknown, that is a. After substituting this value of b in the first equation, you will get the value for a is like this, is -0.2814. Now the next step is here in the actual model, the constants are capital A and capital B. But after solving these normal equations, we get the values for small a and small b. So you have to find out capital A and capital B using this small a and small b. For that, you know the transformation, here we use this logarithm. So you know that log b is equal to capital B. So to get the capital B, you just find out anti-log. It's a reverse process, anti-log of B. That means anti-log of 0.4737. Okay, anti-log of 0.4737. So using the anti-logarithm table, you can find out that value. Okay, if you are not aware of the logarithm, how to check the logarithm and logarithm, I can show you how to find out these things. I think you are familiar with the logarithm. So using the anti-logarithm table, we get the value for b is 2.977. similarly, find out the anti-logarithm for -0.2817. that value is 0.5231. now substitute this a and b in our actual model is y equal to a into b raised to x. So instead of a, using the solution, instead of a you write 0.5231, instead of b is 2.977x. so this is our fitted model. Okay, this is our fitted model. Now here, if you put the given values of x here, you can find out the estimated values of y. Here x is 1 2 3 4 and 5. If you put the values of x here, you can find out the estimated values for y. So from the table you can see that these are the trend values. First you put x equal to 1 in the fitted model, x equal to 1. So putting x equal to 1 in the fitted model, you get the y value is 1.5773, is approximately 1.6. so you check the given value. What about the given value? This also 1.6. so our fit is a very good fit. Okay, this model is suitable for this situation. Now if you put x equal to 2, the fitted value is 4.636. it is approximately 4.6. so 4.6 is the estimated value using our fitted model, but the actual value is 4.5. so there is a small amount of error there. Similarly, when x equal to 3, the value is 13.80 something, that is 13.8. what about the actual value? Is also 13.8. and when x equal to 4, the fitted value is 41.1, that is the approximate value, but the actual value is 40.2. there is a little amount of error there. Okay, when x equal to 5, the trend value is 122.3, but the actual value is 125. What it says that here the model we used is y equal to a b raised to x, and that model is a very good model for explaining this situation. So if you have find out such a model for a situation, you can use that model for prediction also. Suppose x is equal to 10, that is a future value. Okay, then what will happen to the value of y? So to get the value of y when x equal to 10, you just put x equal to 10 into your model. Okay, that is the way to forecast. It's called forecasting. You put the x equal to 10 here. You can find out in the future value of y. This is called forecasting. That is the application of time series. Okay, in the day-to-day life. If you have the number of COVID cases last a few months or few days, then if you find a suitable model to explain the number of COVID cases, then you can use that model to predict how many number of COVID cases in the coming years, coming months or coming days. That is the way of we are using time series model in the real life. Okay, I think you are got the idea behind this modeling. And now use another example. Here census years are given. Census years, census is happening in 10 years period. Okay, so in 1911 the population in crores are given, 25 crores. In 1921, it is 25.1. 1931, these are the figures from the census report. Up to 1971, it is given. Okay. And if you want, you can extend this data by providing the other census figures also. You can use this model to explain the population growth in our country also. So you give the census values in each census years. Here in 1971, up to 1971 is available in this problem. Here it is 54.7. Okay. Now fit an exponential trend, y equal to ab raised to x. Is same as the similar problem that you have already done. Okay. So here x values are given in years. In the previous problem, they are points 1, 2, 3, etc. So the computation was very easy. But here the x values are given in years. So you first transform these x values into a smaller value. The technique, you just subtract the middle value from the from each and every values and divide that values by the interval duration. And here in 1911, after that 1921, so the duration is 10 years. So you first transform these x values into a new variable, it is called u. So how to get u? You just subtract the middle value, middle year from each year. X is years. So x minus middle year is 1941. So x minus 1941, that divided by the duration is 10. So that divided by 10. So using this technique, you can reduce the values of x as y, u. Now your model become a y equal to a b raised to u. Instead of x, you use u. Okay. Now proceed in the same way. You use the two normal equations. First of all, you take the logarithm transformation and find out the linear model for this equation, and then using the normal equations, find the unknown constants. Here you check the table. Here x values are given, y values are given. Okay, y values are given. Then first you transform x as u. So the transformation is subtracting middle year and divide by 10. Now our x values becomes similar values. So the computation is very easy. Then find out the logarithm of y values. That is our new capital Y values. Then find the u square and uy. These four things are needed in the normal equations. Okay, you take the sigma y, then sigma u or sigma x. Here it is sigma u, then sigma y, sigma u square, sigma uy. These terms are required in the normal equation. So for now, you put these values in the normal equations. You will get two normal equations, and you solve that normal equations, you will get the values for capital A and capital B from the normal equations, and you transform that values as small a and small b, because small a and small b are given in the model. Okay, small a and small b are given in the model, the small a and small b. So that is required. Small a and small b, this is the model. So small a and small b, to get small a and small b, you just anti-log, take the anti-log. And after all this, you will get the new model. What about the new model? You substitute these values in the model y equal to a into b raised to x. You get the model is like this. Okay. Here u is x minus 1941 by 10. Okay. Now you supply the given values of u into the model. You will get the trend values. Now check the table. Here in the last column, you can see the trend values. So you first find out the value corresponding to 1911. So for 1911, you know the u value is minus 3. So you substitute that minus 3 in the model, you'll get the value as 2.56. Okay, 2.56. Then is it 2.56? I think there is an error. It may be 25.6, not 2.56. is a printed mistake. It is 25.6, but the actual value is 25. Okay, and for the second year it is 25.76, but the actual value is 25.1. Then for third one it is 27.9, but the actual value is 29.42. Similarly, you can find out the estimated values for each and every point, and you can check that whether the difference is a huge number, the error is huge, or it is an acceptable margin. If the error is very large, so what your conclusion, the model is not a suitable model for that situation. If the error is smaller error, then you can use that model in the practical situations. Okay, so that is about a trend equation, and I will share these materials in Moodle platform. You can work out these examples yourself. And there is one more thing. Suppose the problem is given in years. The values of x are given in years, and you want to convert that years. Suppose you the values are given in years, and you want to find out the trend in a particular month. So what we do to get the values of y corresponding to months, given an annual model. So the technique is you just divide that trend equation by 12, because you know that 1 year is 12 months. Okay, suppose the given model is a linear model, y equal to a plus bx. Here x is given annual figures, that means yearly data are available. So using that model to find out the monthly data, you divide that equation throughout by 12. Okay, so a by 12, b by 12. Then using that model, you can find out the monthly value, monthly value of y. Okay, and suppose the values or x values are in months instead of years, the x values are given in months, then that model becomes a by 12 plus b by 12 into x by 12, because x are given in months. So that becomes b by 12 into 12, it is 144x. Okay. From that model, you can find out the trend values corresponding to a particular month. For that, you check the given month, and from the fixed base month, you add that much month to the x values. Suppose the given month, 1st July, middle of November, November. So the given origin is 1990, 1st July is the given origin value for the observation, and you want to find out the value of y corresponding to 1st July to middle of November. That means 4.5 months. So you need to add 4.5 to the base value of x. So in that model, you put instead of x plus 4.5 is from that point how much points, how much months we want to add. So this way to find out the required months value. So you check this problem. Here this problem trend equation is given. The equation for yearly sales. Yearly sales. The data is yearly with the 1st July 2001. And the fitted model is y equal to a plus bx. A and b are, you can see what are a and b are. Now determine the trend equation to give monthly trend values with the 15th January 2002 as origin. And also calculate the trend value for March 2002, August 2002. These type of questions are frequently asking in university question question paper. So here first you can given model is for yearly data, so first convert that into monthly data. For that the annual trend equation reduced to monthly values. The equation is 81.6 by 12 28.8 by 144 because we need monthly data. Okay, so that becomes y is 6.8 plus 0.2x. so the origin here is 1st July 2001, and we want to find out the value of this value when 15th January 2002. So from the origin 1st July 2001 to 15th January 2002, how many months are there? The months is 6.5 months are there. From first the origin to the required point, 6.5 months are required. So in the x value you have to add 6.5 months to there. So the model becomes 8.1 plus 0.2x. okay, in that way you can find out the trend values for a particular month. Here if you put the x equal to the different months, you will get the sales corresponding to that month. These are the applications of time series analysis in our day-to-day life. And don't worry about this. I will share these materials into your model platform, and you check the model platform and work these examples yourself. Okay, thank you.